I, 2020, bitch, new year, same old piece of shit me. And I thought since it's a new decade, I can show you how my art has evolved through the years and all the paintings and things that I did that got me to where I am, aka begging for views on YouTube. Unfortunately, I don't have any of my old art, the real cringe stuff, because if you didn't know already, I'm hella insecure and afraid of looking bad, so I deleted all of my old art back in 2015 like a little bitch. But I still got plenty of bad art to show you, so don't even worry about that. And you know what? If you're still in that stage where your art looks like it was poured with melted lava and somebody was trying to save it by peeing on it, please save that, because that's going to be part of your history and you can laugh about it later. If there's one piece of advice that I can give to my old self, it would be to overcome my insecurities and stop deleting my old art. Like, your favorite part of Pokemon is seeing the Pokemon actually evolve. And you know what? I have the same struggles with making videos, but for some reason, when I say suck my dick on YouTube, people don't see it as part of the journey.
I don't know why.
With that said, let's dive into the origin of all the cringe art in the world, DeviantArt. So if you go to my DeviantArt, which I wouldn't really recommend, you're gonna find the oldest of my oldest artworks, and it says here that I have over 1,600 artworks. So I bought my first digital tablet back in 2011 when I was 15. I still look 15 now, bitch. But back then, I was still addicted to playing League of Legends, so it pretty much stayed in the closet for 2 years. And then 2013 and 2014, when I started painting, I was pretty much doing the normal DeviantArt shit, aka complaining about stuff and having art block. And I so wish I had all of those paintings just so I can show you that they weren't special at all, but my insecurities were too deep. And then in 2015, my insecurities really kicked in, and I was like, man, fuck this painting shit. I really need to learn how to do realistic portraits. So what I started doing is I would paint for a while, then I'll copy paste an actual photo on top of the painting, and I would just mask it out with even more painting. So those are the oldest artworks that you're gonna find of me. I was just lying to myself that I can paint and trying to show the world that I can do realistic portraits, when in fact I was just mashing photos around and hiding shit. And people blame me a lot for stealing now, but bitch, you should have seen me back then. And I wouldn't recommend anybody do that. Not because it's somehow morally wrong, although I'm pretty sure it is, but simply because it's not getting you anywhere. Like, I didn't learn anything about portrait painting. I didn't go to art school. I didn't watch any tutorials. I was just slapping photos on top of each other, trying to get likes. Hey, but at least you know that I've been about these likes since the beginning. So I was doing my illusion shit, feeling good about myself, and then I graduated from high school in the middle of 2015. And this fucking depression hit me because I realized, what the fuck am I doing with my life? How am I gonna make a living out of this? Like, nobody's gonna pay me to fuck around with their photo and give it back. And I wasn't really interested in going to art school because they made you do all this weird shit that never really made sense to me. Like sculpting and learning art history. Like, what is this, a fucking history lesson? I barely graduated from high school. I don't need any more essays and shit. So I decided that I finally need to learn how to paint. So I put a challenge on myself with this other Facebook artist that I knew back in the day to do one painting study every day for 1 year. And we would choose a different topic to study every week, like monkeys or birds or portraits, and then we'd share it in the Facebook chat. And naturally, my fucking ego and competitive nature kicked in, so I wasn't even seeing it as a learning experience, but I was just trying to beat everybody. And this is the first study that I ever did, and I'll just find photos on Pinterest of the topic that we were supposed to study, and I'll paint for a while, and then I'll put the actual photo inside of the painting, and I'll be like, oh, I'm so fucking good.
Nope.
Honestly, I don't think I even knew what the word credit meant. I was just thinking, man, I'm an artist, baby. This is what we do.
Nope.
So this shit kept going for a couple of months, and I was again just overpainting on photos, but I didn't skip a single day, and all of the artists that I started with all started skipping, and then slowly but surely all of them gave up. So now I was like, fucking great, I don't have anybody to impress anymore, I guess I'll have to finally learn how to paint. So So I decided that I also needed to learn how to draw traditionally, because up until that time, the only thing that I used a pencil for was probably picking boogers out of my nose. So on top of the 1 year challenge, I also decided I should be doing daily figure studies. But I read somewhere that if you actually use newsprint paper and a charcoal, it'll be much cheaper than using normal paper and a pencil. So I went to this factory and I was like, hey, can I get 100 pages of newsprint? And they're like, there ain't no pages in here, boy, just show me how much you want. And I was like, okay, I want this much. And they were like, okay, that'll be $5. So I think I got like 2,000 pages of newsprint, and my whole wardrobe was full of that shit. So I started doing 2 drawings a day, every single day, the digital painting and the traditional sketch, and I think I was drawing like 12 hours a day. I had time only to eat, sleep, and go to the gym, and occasionally jerk off while crying. So this is where I really started learning how to draw. I was watching Proko, I read Andrew Loomis, I learned some perspective, some anatomy, but mainly I just kept doing photo studies. And I also realized that even though I was quote unquote painting with color for years, I didn't even understand how color works. So I just kept doing black and white studies, and then I'll go back to color just to test myself. And people often ask me how much you should be doing studies and how much you should be drawing from imagination for fun. And the thing is, I never had fun drawing from imagination because I was never good at that shit. I just wanted to learn how to paint something pretty. I was never like, oh my god, you can't believe what's in my head. There's just only cookies and anal sex there. And artists always talk about, oh my god, I have so many unfinished pieces, but I always thought that shit is stupid as hell, because if you don't push yourself to finish something, you don't really get the whole skill out of it. So I just chose the topic for the week, like black and white female portraits, and whatever I started, I literally finished in 24 hours, because I was only worried about getting the skill and then moving on to the next one. Like zombies, avatar, fashion studies, whatever the fuck, you name it, I found reference and I did a study. And again, I don't know if that shit was the best thing to do. I don't even know if it was right. I just saw myself getting better and I just kept doing it, because I wasn't going to be one of those people, oh my god, I have an art block. So I got pretty fucking good at just painting what I'm seeing without copy pasting the photo on top. So after that 1 year ended, I had already decided I'm gonna do 2 more years, one where I do fantasy stuff and the other one where I combine both fantasy and copying. So now I was doing all these goofy characters and illustrations, and they were still inspired by other people, but I had to come up with the idea and the composition and all this shit. Like, I'll just find pictures of reptiles and I'll turn them into dragons, or I'll find pictures of old people and turn them into elves or orcs or whatever the fucking topic of the week was. And meanwhile, I was doing these horrible traditional sketches, just learning how to draw with a pencil, just no idea how to shade, no idea how to render. I just kept doing 2 drawings every single day. And I've always believed that the secret to art is just quantity. Like, nobody told me what to do or what to study. I just believe that if you just kept increasing slowly the complexity of your art, you're just gonna get better. And I really wish I had a mentor, or at least somebody to talk to, because I feel like I wasted so much time practicing useless shit. But even with that, the quantity of your work is gonna smooth out all your problems. And nowadays, people send me something on my Patreon live streams and they're like, here, I drew the planes of the head one time, did I get it right? And it's like, bitch, go back to the basement, you spoiled ass motherfucker. So I just come up with weird ideas, like combining animals or drawing guys like zombies. Like, whatever it came, just so I can move on to the next subject. And the same with traditional. I was doing portraits, then I got back to figures. And then for the first time ever, I was interested in stylized work, and I wanted to learn how to draw animated shit. So I started doing studies from Disney movies. And then when 2017 came, some shit started happening, because I remember I drew this illustration with water and a stag, because the topic was landscapes, and I finished it and I was like, oh man, I'm an artist now. So I completed my second year, the fantasy stuff, in the middle of 2017, and I just remember thinking like, man, I'm so excited to get back to studies. And I think that's the time I realized, like, I don't like this fantasy stuff, like drawing orcs and guys, like, fuck that shit, I just want to draw pretty stuff. So that's what I did. I just kept finding cool references and trying to paint them even cooler. And is that really art? I don't know. That's just what I liked. And with traditional, my portraits were becoming a lot better, but they still looked kind of plain. And I remember seeing these artworks by Queenie Art, Keenie Art, and they were both traditional and super colorful. And I was like, man, I want to learn how to do that. And by the way, that's how I learn anything. I just find something that inspires me and I'm like, man, I want to learn how to do that. And then I just keep practicing some wrong shit until I find what's the right things to practice, and then ta-da, magic, bitch. So I wanted to do these traditional drawings with a lot of colors, but then I realized they're actually horrible because I'm not as good as Cine Art, so I think I'm just gonna stick to one color. And I did this drawing of a girl eating a fruit, and I just kind of made the fruit glow, and lo and behold, that shit got a lot of likes. So I was like, okay, I guess I need to do a lot more of that. And I just kept going, and then people started copying me, and I was like, wait, I know I've been stealing from other people since fucking forever, but how about you stop stealing from me? No fucking karma, bitch. Then I realized that it strokes my ego even more if I'm the one that you copy. So now I'm like, fucking redraw my art, copy it, fucking pee on it, whatever you choose. And again, is that morally right? I don't know. Probably not. I think it's a personal choice. And if you haven't noticed by now, my moral compass is kind of janky. Oh boy, I'm gonna get so hated for this. Hey, but I'm trying to credit people now, right? Right? Anyway, my third year challenge ended in the summer of 2018, and I had so many paintings that I could just keep posting every day on Instagram without even painting. And that's when I think I kind of got unfocused, because I started going out trying to make up for 3 years of staying at home, and I was still painting, but I wasn't giving it my full attention. So I think at the end of 2018, I kind of got stuck with my art and doing the same things that I was doing in 2017. And then when 2019 came, I was like, oh shit, I'm not gonna get to my goals like this. I need to get focused and start posting every day again. But I also realized that if I didn't want to end up homeless or with a job, which is probably even worse, I needed to do something more than just paint every day. And by the way, if you're asking yourself how I was able to stay home and paint for 3 years, it's because of my dope-ass parents, because I'm living with them and my dad was giving me money. But that shit can't keep going forever, and I promised them that no matter what, I'm gonna move out in 5 years. Even if I'm homeless, just give me some time, I need to figure out some shit. So I need to move out by the end of 2020, and 2019 I realized, wow, that's next year. Like, I've been so focused on getting better that I completely forgot that there's, you know, like, life and shit. So that's when I started live streaming, I set up my Patreon, I opened up a merch store, you know, just working on my brand. And last year, I was posting like 4 times a week, just because I was busy with all the other stuff. But my art has evolved in different directions, and I still heavily use references, but I feel like with so much practice, I've actually developed a feeling of just knowing how to paint it better than it looks in the reference. And I also started my weekly Draw This In Your Style challenge, which got banned because I was sharing other people's photos, and then I started doing fantasy characters, still heavily inspired by other people, and then that shit got banned as well, because I guess people didn't really like me anymore with all my stealing shit. But somebody gave me the great idea of doing a different hashtag every week, so I'm bringing my weekly challenge Draw With Angel, and I'm even gonna do an art book called Draw With Angel with all the characters and the stories and like small tutorials in the back, really unique, kind of like Loish. So these are my plans for 2020, man. I want to keep pushing my art, keep adding these goofy quotes on the bottom, because nostalgia is hitting your boy pretty hard. And I'm sorry, I got the aesthetics of a 13-year-old white girl. And I'm not even sure where I want to take this, but I was even more unsure in 2015, so it's all good. And I'm going to be doing a lot of tutorials, because I want to release the ultimate painting course, but I first need to learn how to teach this shit. But you have to remember that all my experience comes from me copying photos and learning this shit by myself. I've never been to art school, and I kind of disagree with a lot of the advice that they give you there, but you know, you probably disagree with a lot of the things that I'm saying, so it's all good. It's not really good. I just want to get better, man, at painting and coaching and teaching and fucking that too. So stay tuned, man, a lot more to come. Check out my Patreon, I do critiques over there. I have a mentorship. Check out my Twitch, I live stream every week. You know, I don't know much about anything, but I have an opinion on everything, so ask me questions, whatever, and I'm gonna talk to you next week.
bitch. Ha!